today we are going to sum up the lesson. It's the concluding up of theme 2, lesson number 6, from the animal food to the growing food, the earliest people. So till now we have discussed about up to the part 12, from gathering the food, how we gather from the forest, how they understand it, like what shape they make, about the rocks, places of the rock size, paintings, all we have to get this. Now we will be going from to now this the second aspect, like growing the crop. Till now we are getting to know like how they had nomadic life, how they were existed, collection of all the three aspects. Now they started growing. So regarding that one, from the page of 51, from gathering.
Major changes in the climate of the world as it increasingly became cold. It led to
like what the animals he started doing was, he started going the animals of herders. Herders means the animals taking care, like cattle, sheep, goat, donkey, all. So with this herders also, they are easily getting the milk, then meat, then at the same time they were also being using the animal skin. These aspects they are also getting benefit. And some animals like ox, some animals like donkeys, so all they also started using the animal for the work, loading the things from one place to other places, the animals coming to fields. So in this way, learning from the law, making the cropping patterns and telling on the animals, process has been begun. Now finally we will come to the domestication, how they have been came into existence. People usually select those kinds of animals that give good yield. Yield means good for aspect. But I am not prone to disease. Seeds of such crops are selected and used for sowing in the next season when only animals of selected types are allowed to breed. Thus, plants and animals tended by people became different from the wild ones. When people sow selected the crops and protected them till they bear fruits, or when they allow selected animals to breed and protect them for their own use, it is called domestication. As I have said up here, taking care of the crops, animals with that procedure is known as a domestication. So in the domestication also, not all the animals have been taken care of, they have been breeding, like animals which have been used and how they are in return what they have been getting. And regarding the crops also, they are not showing all the crops to that place. At the same time, water they have also been seeing, de-seeding the crop which has been get damaged, and it is been, which the seed which gives a good crop. So that's the kind of seeds which has been not related to any kind of diseases. So the such kind of seeds they have been selecting the plants and selecting the animals, so that taking care of that, it has been known as domestication. In this way, over hundreds of years, people bred and propagated plants and animals beneficial to them in some special ways. So likewise, it has been started taking care of the plants and animals. It has been beneficial to them in many some other ways. Of course, not all the people took growing crops or raiding animals. Many people continue to hunt and gather in the forest. And again, not all the people practice agriculture in the same way. Initially, the people practice shifting agriculture like Kodo, discussed in the fifth lesson, and also combined a little hunting and gathering from the forest along with the growing crops. So like I have been saying, not all the type of people, these early people, they not became growing of the crops, tending of animals, domestication. Only few people. Some other few people, they still depend on the forest to hunt animals, to get the natural resources what they have been getting. Some other third group people, they have been growing the cropping pattern, agriculture, clearing of the land, like photo agriculture, shifting agriculture or dune cultivation. So likewise, and at the same time they also been hunt the little bit of hunting they also been doing up. So basically three categories of aspect has been changed. Some are doing the agriculture, tending the animals, some are being still dependent on the nature, like forest hunting as the same. Some are depending on the prototype of agriculture, little bit of hunting. So likewise, according to their convenience, according to their thing, these kind of changes have been happened in the aspect of domestication. Next, some of them realize that the fertility of the soil could be maintained by tilling and using manure. When they began much grain that they would not eat all at once. It has to be stored for long periods, for about 6 months to 1 year. All this meant that people had to stay in one place and build houses to store the grain. So likewise, several livelihoods when they have started growing crops, it will be used more than they required. So that needs to be stored. So how to store? It will be for 6 months or 1 year according to the crop, how much it is being used. Now for that purpose, taking care of the crop, seeding, all the aspects, they need to build the house and they need to live in that particular period of time for a long one. Because they need to protect the plants, these crops from the wild animals, if they get damaged, all these aspects, because of that reason, they are being started living in one particular separate place. Now, when staying in one place became inevitable, they constructed the house of stone, wood, mud and dry grass. So living in one place is not an easy aspect of. So instead of that one, they started making the houses of stones with the help of mud, with the help of wood, with the help of brick. So in this way, they had been constructed their houses to settle there. Next, the vessels have been required to store the liquid like animals or things made. The next grains, all this they have been required to make the vessels. So vessels can be used to cook grain, store water, milk, etc. It led to make the pots of different kinds. They also started painting and decorating the pots to make them look better. Cooking also required stamps and stones for grinding corn, etc. When archaeologists dig up the places where early farmers lived, they usually found remains of huts, pots, stuffs, microliths and grinding stone in some places. They also found some roasted grains. So now these people, what they did on the houses they constructed with the help of big stones, wood, grass, basically that dry grass, like thatch type of roof, mud. Next of all, vessels for storing, they also made the vessels with the help of clay, objects or the sources which they have been getting out for cooking also required. So in this way, the decorated pots they used to make the do the paintings, drawings to look very beautiful. Next, for grinding the animal meat or the grains, they started using of the stones, from big stones made to small, that is a microlith. So after these presents, the archaeological people, the archaeologists, when they have been finding out, excavations has been happened, they find out the remains of the hut, they find out these small pots, they find out the roasted grains which they have been stored. So all these aspects that has been get found out, and these they have been get preserved, like how many years it was before, like technical part, some designs, patterns or something related to these people, these archaeological people, they were aware, they getting to know that this belongs to this many years before, like all this aspect. Now next is, the early farmers needed to clear the forest by cutting trees and branches. They created a new kind of stone tool which is called neolith. So I will say, for growing of the crops here, the farmers, these early people, the forest area need to be kept clear. It has been highly impossible to make such big stones into the small phenomena. So new tools has been made to cut the trees and the branches. So that new kind of stone tool is known as neolithic. The early farmers selected the right kind of stone which are ground on the rock to give it like axe like edge. This axe head was being then fixed to a wooden handle and used to cut the trees, etc. By growing crops with the new tools, the early people began a process which changed almost all the aspects of their life in a fundamental manner. This period of early agriculture is known as Neolithic period, named after the new tool, Neolith. So what are the present after settling down, after growing with the crop, a new lifestyle with the help of stones they have been made. So that is being known as Neolithic period of time, or as Neolith. So big stones they have been tying out, using one for the other purpose. So here now we are going to have it for the figures 6.13, then 6.14, 6.15 and 6.16 from the page of 53.
this is a figure. An old pot, not exactly this old pot, the same as it is, these archaeological people did not find, only the small pieces. So with the small pieces they used to create and they used to imagine that the things would might be like this. Next here figure, an archaeologist have found it or the remains of the food preserved some 12,000 years ago. Like this is what, like the food grains or which has been get preserved through the bark of the tree, plants, all this one. Now next is here the axe. In the regarding the figure 6.5, all the new stone tools. These are the new such kind of tools of related with the Neolithic. Like see how the stone, they have been tied with the things and with the help of wooden stick. So these stones, Mahabubnagar district, this is from Nagar Kanol, this is, so all these, this has been known as Neolithic period of time. Now coming to the last conclusion part out here, and before that we'll be going to get to know about the inbox questions which is from related to the page of 52. So do the farmers still use domestication method to select the better seeds for the next year, like the aspect. Now next question here, why do the people think, why do the people protect the crops they selected to sow? Then why, how do the people protect the animals what they wanted to be related with the agricultural aspect. Now coming to the page of 54, the other three inbox questions which have been get related. So first is, how do you think the early people store grains? Next is, why do people grow crops have to stay in the same place for a long period of time? Imagine and draw hut used by the early people, what they, how they are different from ours. So this is what about the early man, their lifestyle which is been going to relate, how the lifestyle, different kinds of houses they have been get carried out, done. Now we will be going to get to know what are the evidences which has been get found out by the archaeological excavations finding up. So relating to this one, we find the earliest evidence of cultivation of crops from Baluchistan about 3,500 period of time ago. So Baluchistan means it has been India, then Pakistan, to my right side I am saying that, just imagine the thing, India, then next it goes to the Pakistan, Afghanistan, then Baluchistan. So that places, because from these thousands of years before, India was not divided, it has been the complete subcontinent of Asia. So this is what being we can see here, like India here, the next basically here, India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, then Baluchistan. So basically northeastern parts where it has been found. So Baluchistan is a place. In that place, these cultivation of the crops has been found out some 10,000 years ago. Now whereas coming to India, it is been evidences, means proof has been found out in the north part of India, that is Kashmir, 5,000 years ago. Then again, Bihar's basically, I think the holy or any religious action, you can ask your elders, your parents, your grandparents, what is meant by a cow dung, alcohol, if it will get dried, if it will get used during the special, especially during the festival period of time. So likewise, this ash mounds, neolithic stones, the next rudimentary pots is the rough of the pots, not the complete pot figure which I have shown you, not the same size or same complete pot. Rudimentary means small, small pieces which they have imagined that it will be not related, it might be of the pot. So it's like ash mounds related with the next thing are it is Neolithic stone axes, stone blades, stone tools, or this sedimentary rock material pots. All these things has been found out by the archaeological excavations. So in our country towards the different places. Now next comes last is about the Neolithic period in Telangana. So Neolithic period. So Neolithic period in our state. Neolithic means new. From the page of this 55, so all the question and answers, then we are also mapping skills also been given. This place, only these places you have been going to look at. Now on the next page of 56, this activity you have been going to do what in the textbook only. This activity, no need to go with the project work. This is of textbook page of 56. No project work, only this activity you have been going to do in your textbook only. Like first one, there are what is the question? They were the shelters of the early people. First one here means likewise. Only the first one I'm just getting to know you here. These were the shelters of the earliest people. Like f- first one cross like this, the arrow marks also been given, or the down, then across, this type of arrow marks it has been given. So here the fifth one, cave, C-A-V-E-S. So here they have been given the fifth one. So likewise you have been going to do this sort of the activity, which has been going to relate this activity in your textbook only.
I'll be just mentioning to write down here regarding the notes here. Questions.